Hello, and welcome to another session of 5 Minutes with Franza. I'm your host, Dr. Thomas Franza. Today, we're going to be covering ghosting using Symantec Ghost version 8.2. This is the Enterprise Edition. First thing you need to do is boot your PC from either a CD or a floppy disk that's got the Ghost program on it. When it boots on up, you have to make sure it's configured for the right network drivers, and we could do a whole other session on that. But we're not going to today. We just want to cover the ghosting process itself. Once the machines are booted, you're going to boot one and then the other. Okay, the machine on my left is the machine that needs to be ghosted, meaning it needs the image put upon it. The machine on the right is the one that has the image. So this one is called my master. I simply set the enter key, and what we're going to do is we're going to do a peer-to-peer TCP/IP, and this one is the master. The master means it is the one that has the image we want. Over here, we're going to do almost the same exact thing. We're going to go peer-to-peer. We're going to choose TCP/IP, and we're going to choose slave. Okay, what's going to happen is that you're going to see over here, it's going to tell you the IP address of this machine. We need to put this into the master one. So we come over to the machine to the right, and we're going to put in the IP address, 149. Now this IP address is going to be different depending on where you are, because we're doing it here, it's going to be the 149 set. If you had like a Linksys router, it might be 192.168.1 dot something. Okay, make sure you put in the number properly, because if you don't, it will not work. Okay, excuse me, we'll reach on over, we say okay. You notice I come back to almost like the same looking machine before, but some of my options are different. Now in this case, we're going to choose disk. To disk. Okay, I'm going to say okay. Okay. See, it's kind of boring. Okay. And it says proceed with disk clone. Destination drive will be overwritten. Whenever you ghost a machine, it's going to wipe out the machine that is the slave, meaning everything on it will be gone. So you need to make sure that if you had any data or any other information, that you got it when you before you do this. Otherwise, it will be gone. Okay, I also like to read over here. You see, it tells me my source, right? My local drive, and it tells me my destination, which is my remote drive. So I know my local drive is gonna be good, my master, and I know my destination drive is gonna be overwritten, okay? I move it over to yes, notice on no by default, hit enter, and let it go. And what you're going to do is you're going to see some numbers are going to pop up over here. I'm 0% done. It's giving me my speed in megabits per minute. I have the amount that's copied. These numbers will jump up and down until they get to a happy point. Okay, we're going to come back to this in roughly 27 minutes when it is complete to take the next.
Okay, we're back, and as you can see, we're winding down. We got about 18 seconds left to go. I should let you know that if you're ghosting, in this case, these machines have a program on them called Deep Freeze, you need to set the clone flag on the master. When you boot the machine up before you ghost, you go into Deep Freeze, and one of the first options is just set clone flag. Check that off. Then when you reboot, you boot with your ghost disk. But again, shouldn't be a problem if you don't have Deep Freeze. So, here we go. It says reset the computer. And on the other one, it says reset the computer. I like to, at this point, pop out the disk, hit enter, and do the same thing. Pop out the disk, and hit enter. Okay, now, for the master, it's really not a big deal. It just boots up and it's happy. As for the other one, you're about to see that it's probably going to ask for a reboot. Once the machine comes up, I'll show you. As you can see, the machine booted up, and as I told you, it's saying, I'm not completely and totally happy. Can you let me restart? So you simply just click on yes. I like to give it a couple of moments just in case there's anything else that may kind of pop up. So if you do get a couple of new hardware detections, even though you're ghosting it, even from the same exact machines like we're doing in this case, it still works. It should also be noted that if you're gonna ghost, you really do want to ghost like machines. Don't ghost your Sony to your Dell, or even your Dell to your Dell if they're two different model numbers. So you're gonna get all sorts of weird stuff when it reboots. Sometimes it will work, sometimes it won't. Depends on chipsets and how different the machines truly are. But in this case, a simple ghost from one machine to another that are the same kind, that's it. I hope you enjoyed this episode of 5 Minutes with Franza and found it useful. Once again, I'm your host, Dr. Thomas Franza. Thank you for watching.